I'm standing here today to discuss the living condition at the University of Lowell. My experience living at the school has been unique and encapsulated. Here, students live in a world of theory and ideology. Many of us are here to learn what is right and prepare for the real world. However, it is difficult to learn about the world when you are living cloistered from it. So today, we will venture into a land not 5 minutes from where we live. This land surrounds us, yet it is a radically different culture.
I think we have to educate people to break away from the stereotypes that not only fags get AIDS. I'm serious.
Yeah.
Everyone can get it, you know?
Okay, so are you going to, like, try to vote for the AIDS president? Which president do you think is, like, the best for AIDS? That's our biggest problem.
Tough question.
The president's not going to stop.
Hi, can I ask you a few questions? We're students at the university, and we were wondering, what do you think is the greatest problem in the world?
The what?
The biggest problem in the world today.
Like, the baby?
Faces mankind, you know, like, the biggest problem that mankind faces today in the world, the biggest problem in the world is today.
What do you think is the biggest problem in the world?
The war.
The war?
The war, yes. It's so stupid. Cambodia.
And what do you, since you've been here, how long have you been here in the U.S.?
I've been here like about 10 years.
10 years?
Since I got here. First we live in New York and then we moved here.
So how come you can't, how come you come from New York to Lowell?
By car.
Like, oh, how come? What, why?
The living condition there is not good.
Yeah. Like, what do you think of Lowell?
It's nice.
You like it?
Yeah.
What do you think about the U.S.?
It's good. Used to, but now business is getting a little more.
Would you like to see any changes in the area?
Yeah, I would like to see the business improve. So.
Do you think this is like, is this a good place for, like, would you raise children here, or would you rather move out of the city?
I don't know anything about that because I don't have family yet.
Oh, okay.
They're living like
that. Okay. Thank you, sir.
What's your name?
My name?
Yeah.
Jonathan.
Well, we'll get that later. We'll get that later.
Okay.
So. What do you, have you lived anywhere else?
Yeah.
Where?
Texas, Killeen, PR, Lowell.
Ah, what do you think of Lowell?
I don't know, it's cool.
It's cool?
Yeah.
You go to school at the high school? No? Where do you go to school?
I mean, I'm locked up now, you know? I'm in D1, yes.
What do you want to, like, do when you get older? Like, for a job or whatever?
I don't know, it's hard to know.
Hard to know?
Yeah.
How about, do either of you know what you want to do once you get it out of school?
I do not know.
No idea?
Nah.
Where are you guys from?
Lowell.
Originally?
Yeah.
Lowell.
Lowell? How do you like it here? Is there, you run into any problems or anything?
Not me.
Families are all right?
Yeah. Just about everybody knows me here, so there ain't no problem there.
Yeah. Okay.
You've been in on it, you know? Maybe you guys are ass kicked, or,
yeah,
or maybe they do something about it, but
all they do
if you stay calm down, you know, they never do nothing.
When you come next to them and say something, they just don't do anything.
They don't, so
well,
it's our,
it's, trying to prove
they just
is
act
that,
like,
you know, a lot of times, the administration is like, oh, you know, it's not safe, and
people
it,
just
so
kind of like,
you think it's
assume,
like,
people assume that it's a certain way, but it's not, you know.
People
that's just
say
a bunch of rumors, and, you know.
So it's pretty safe down here?
Yeah, it's safe. I know many people. You can walk down the street even at night and nobody's gonna do nothing to you.
Really?
Yeah, I know many people that say, yo, man, if you got a throat, you can call me, you know. But everyone from down here to down there, they know me, everywhere.
Are you, what religion are you?
None.
What? None? Do any of you go to church or synagogue or anything? Are you Catholic? Where are you?
Pentecostal.
What do you think of Lowell?
What we think of Lowell?
Yeah.
Well, Lowell changed a lot. There's no jobs or nothing.
There's no jobs.
No jobs. No nothing. People need free jobs.
What do you think should be done?
Well, they should make some more housing buildings.
Housing?
Yeah.
Yeah?
There's a lot of people. And they're taking welfare away. Some of us need welfare to stay alive.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
There's a lot of people, especially on this street, that live out homeless.
Like, look at all the buildings they closed down.
Yeah, we were told, like, not to come down here alone. Like, there's a lot of crime. Is there a lot of crime? Or is that, like, a myth? No?
No, that's not a crime. It was just the drug dealer. Don't go down and they get your head busted, you know?
No, that's not why. Well, if you come here and you try to get nasty with somebody, they're going to hit you, yeah, but that's about it.
Are the cops friendly or are the cops, like, brutal? They're out. Why is that?
They are.
They're mean.
They're mean. Like, if we stand down on you, they tell us to leave. Or if they stop you, like, to search you or something, they'll beat you up.
Really? Do you think they're racial? It's racial? Is it a racial problem? Yes. Definitely.
They won't even let us sit down in the stairs.
Is it on television?
Or talk in front?
No. Really? They won't let you sit on the stairs?
No. If they say get out, if we come back. Testify again, they throw us out. Or they're
that's called trespassing.
And he just came down from Puerto Rico not too long ago, and they don't even want him down here because they say it's a bad influence.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you think there's a big police brutality problem?
Yeah.
All right. What do they like?
There's no rule that says you cannot wait on a public sidewalk. We pay taxes and we're Americans just like everybody else. And there's no rule that says we cannot hang here. It's not hanging around, but what happens with people who wait for the bus? They don't have no buses to bring the students to school no more. So we gotta wait for a public bus and we can't even hang on the sidewalk.
Did you hear about, I heard about the 10-year-old boy. There was like a 10-year-old boy who was beaten up over there. Oh.
Is that true?
Did you hear anything about that?
No. I live in Lawrence now, but I come up here a lot because my mother lives here. But the bump.
Yeah, that's the bump that they gave you?
Yep.
For standing around?
Nope. Fighting.
For fighting,
No, but see, if there's going to be a fight or a riot, I understand, you know, to clear the area. But for, like, stupidity, just for standing here and just waiting, or you don't know somebody's waiting for someone to get out of school, because a lot of people wait for their sisters or their girlfriends to get out of school, and you can't even be there. Around the school, yeah, but what's downtown? That's more than 200 feet from the school. A fraternity from the college, okay? Uh-huh. I'm not trying to say them, but if you have, like,
a
fraternity from the college in one corner, and you have us on another corner, I will guarantee you we will get put out before the fraternity.
I think so.
Am I right or wrong?
Definitely.
Right? That's my point.
Because they're alumni of the school.
But that has nothing to do with it. If there's a fight, they're there for a reason too, right?
Yeah.
And they're all together, so if they hit one of their friends, you know the whole alumni is going to get in it.
Yeah.
So if they hit one of my friends, I'm going to get in it too.
Yeah, definitely. All right.
Dale, otra vez.
Now, what happens when you encounter the police in Lowell generally, what you've heard? What happens?
They arrest you. If you're doing something wrong, it's necessary to arrest you. And if you resist, they'll use any force there is to get you.
Yeah, like, have you heard of anything specific? You know?
Not really, I have.